How I met Unhlanhla, actually this one time I was checking into for camp, actually it was 2010. Newbie, don't know anyone, you know, so this guy was just, you know, that vibe. So I thought, you know what, this one, definitely gonna befriend him at camp. Got to camp, he was busy and you know what, we couldn't have a chat or anything like that. Until somehow he saw me and he just asked me for ice cream. Then we went out, had ice cream, started chatting, and the rest is history. And we still enjoy ice cream actually till date. So yeah, that's how I met Unhlanhla.
How Katie and I met is we met at church. I was doing a church camp at Grace Bible Church. And she was just being my normal self, being loud, crazy. And I helped her out and we had a little vibe nyana. And then we actually met up later at camp in 2010, the same campsite. And yeah, man, we went out for ice cream and we had some really good vibes and the rest is history.
The most special thing that I know Unhlanhla is that he has a love for literally the whole of humanity. You know, he's very consistent in everything he does, you know. I think that's one thing that attracted me to him, because if he's genuine with one, you know, you don't have to be the select elect, you know, for him to be kind with you. He's like that with everyone across the board. That's what something I really, really like about him. Fondest memory with Unhlanhla, I think when we met, it was interesting how we met, you know. He used to call me friend, you know, so he made it clear, but when are you friends or, you know?
The first time we went out was actually at Nando's. The chicken was nice. So we actually had a really, really good time. So yeah, that's my fondest memories.
I think you've given me one gift that's very special, you know. You've made me a wife. You've given me love, you know, it's priceless. And every time I'm with you, I see the God in you, you know. I love you for, you love me, you know, for healing my heart. You know, you want to make the pots, you know, the things that make, the things to happen. And you've always been that, you know, and you've always been true to your word. And I really, really love that about you, you know. And I think, yeah, to the next lifetime. And I love that every time I'm with you, like everything, you know, just feels right, you know. I feel like it's the right place to be, you know. And there's never been a day where you've made me feel somehow about myself. And every day's just been honeymooning, you know. So to the next lifetime of honeymoons, I really love you, Takasami, and cheers to the honeymoon.
Excited that I'm marrying my best friend, my dog, Njayami, you know, my best apomba. I think, yo, man, I'm looking forward to really building, achieving more dreams and really just making sure that we build up a really amazing home. We started on a really, really fantastic note, and I think the best is still to come. Yeah.